The Xtreme Bass Angler is presented by Go Fish in Ontario. It's catching Strike King Lure Company, over 50 years of domination. St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Sportsman Protein Shake, power your obsession.
Here, fishy, fishy. Hey, this week on the Xtreme Bass Angler, we're going to the bank. Which bank's that? This bank right here. In any bank that I think potentially has fish holding bass, logs, weeds, trees, bushes, overhanging cedars, you name it. Hey, even artificial man-made stuff, I don't care. If I think a fish could be on it, I'm going there this week because we all love to bust the bank for bass. What am I gonna use? Hey, listen to this. That's just a jig. There's no route, there's no rattle, there's no sound, there's nothing, just the jig. The little skirt. I got another jig with rattle back and forth. I'm gonna fish this grass with the jig to try to get those first aggressive reaction strikes. And if I work stuff, and I'm almost positive that that bank or that little spot, the vault I call it, has got a fish or should have a fish, I'll put it down, pick up soft plastics, little beaver baits, worms, craws, it doesn't matter, anything potentially to catch fish. So this week, sit back, strap in, and get ready, because we're going to the bank and make some withdrawals of largemouth bass in summertime in Ontario. Okay, here's the trick I'm doing with these jigs. I'm fishing wood and different grass, overhanging trees and stuff, so I don't need a real big weed guard. So I'll just trim some of it off, obviously flare it. Then I got a small chunk on there, but those legs are a little bit longer than I like. I want a nice small profile. So all that happens is a little jig and the little claws stick out like a little crayfish. Smaller profile, short haircut, trim the weed guard a bit. That's all you need, increasing your hooking percentage right there. It's bass time. Chunker, they're getting bigger. Look at that. Common denominator, both under trees, huh? Or actually three under trees. We just haven't got the size we're looking for. Chunky little black bass from Northern Ontario, huh? Go on, you. Go on. That jig is scary, man. I got that little chunk trailer at the back that I just push up. I tuck up between the rattle. See that? Listen to this. You see to yourself, spook them. No way. That rattle, I don't care. Crystal clear water and dark water, they can hear it when I shake it. And I shake it up because I want to catch. Let's go. Okay, when I'm busting the banks, you know, I'm sure this is my focus, this stuff. Overhanging trees, shade, and different things, okay? But be aware, look what, you know, trees that have fallen in the shoreline, creeks that maybe come out, and, you know, the weed growth goes out a bit farther and stuff, work that stuff. So yeah, you're still in the bank, but it'd be crazy to ignore the things on your right hand and left hand side, depending where you're fishing. A tree going out, you know, a submerged tree, a bush, some different pads and stuff. Be aware, fish all the stuff that's in front of you, the things that are very obvious, like the overhanging trees and stuff, but man, if you got logs and you got weeds or pads or anything that goes out and it's tapering to deep water, those are potential hot spots. Do not ignore that. So fish the trees, yes. Make your pitches and look for those ones that are in ambush spots, but never neglect these big logs that go out and taper to deeper water. See that little flash? We're getting juniors today. Shoreline juniors, little shoreline fish. Where's the big ones, huh? Where? The jig goes in, jig really comes out, just small fish. But hey man, fish in the tree, look over and see that bush. He's on the bush, he ain't on the tree. I gotta dissect it and see if I can find one on the tree. Let's see. Wow, where'd you come from? Swimming bugger, eh? He must have chased the other one out. He was up high in one of the branches. Swimming that jig and just came out of nowhere. Whoa! You think he wants to eat? Oh, he wants to eat. Again, just a little chunky. We need a 3 to 5 pounder to do that. We need a 3 to 5 pounder to come out and do that. Okay, here's the tools of the trade. I'm fishing on this, the 7.6 St.Croix Legend Xtreme, medium heavy, 20 pound gamma edge fluorocarbon on all these sticks I'm busting the bank. This one, I got little 5/16, 3/8, and 1/4 ounce tungsten weights, all depending on how shallow it is or how much of a taper and shorelines I'm gonna fish. Little soft plastics, some with little kicking tails. Another option, obviously, is the St.Croix Avid X 7.4 heavy action, 20 pound, obviously. And this one, same little tungsten, it's pegged. It's got more of just a flat bait. This one's called the rodent. It doesn't have a lot of action. It just glides down. So it just gets in those spots. Those fish see it, they're gonna eat it. And last but not least, when I'm breaking the bank, I have to have a jig on. 1/2 ounce and 3/8. I got two different colors. Black with a little bit of gray and black with blue. And then I've got the copper with the green. So crayfish tones, little jig. I trim it back a little bit just to give it a little smaller profile. This has the 25 pound gamma edge fluorocarbon on my St.Croix big jig rod because it's big bass day, robbing the banks for bass. Oh, that's a monster. Look at this. Oh, that's what I'm talking about right there. Hey, right there. Cruise along the shoreline right there. Look at him. Whoa, look how these things scrap, hey? Do you want to come in the boat? Oh yeah, right there. That's what I'm talking about right there. Big mouth bass. Look at the mouth on that thing. Think that's got a big mouth? Look at that. When you say big mouth, that's what I mean about pitching to every single thing I see on the shorelines, man. Every single thing. See, that's what I'm looking for right there. But look at the mouth. Potential to be an absolute brute. Just saw him swimming. Put him in for some pictures. Okay, picture fish sitting in shallow water. Right there, beautiful bass. Nice and slow and methodical. Taking my time, let's put these down for a sec. And just, you know, it's only the, well, what is it? July 4th, I don't know, happy birthday, USA. But I mean, I went and tried some of the deeper trees overhanging and stuff in Squatolo, you know. I started off in some trees that were shallow close to spawning bays, got some smaller fish, lost one about 3 pounds. Then I said, forget that deeper stuff. I went back into another area, little bay with some boathouses, and I saw 2 3-pounders swimming around, one guarding fry. They haven't spawned that far long ago. Came out back here, fished a deep dock, got a pounder, come along the shoreline, and what's roaming? Big fat mouth fish like that. Keep your bait wet and you will catch them. Let's keep going and keep finding these fish in the shallow water along the bank. Okay, here's another scenario. I got a couple more trees coming up right in front of me here. They're tapering off to that deeper water and stuff. And I'm always ready. I got the jig ready, but I've got my secondary bait, which is my little soft plastic rigged on a wide gap hook, tungsten weight. Again, different size depending on how deep I'm fishing. This is 5/16, and I can make my pitches. When you got individual logs like this, those fish know real quick when you put it in. Look for the darkest spot, the most tangled spot, the craziest spot, and fish that. But have variety and be prepared. Plastic jig, they're right beside me. When I need it, they're there. Just a confidence thing. Sometimes they eat the plastic, sometimes eat the jig. But always being prepared. Another thing is, I've always got my pocket full of baits, right here, see? Full of baits, not playing around. Wasting time going back and forth into my boxes and stuff and grabbing baits, you know? Time on the water, man. Use it efficiently. You know, maybe not as competitive, and you think, well, so what? I'll go back, get some baits and stuff, but when I'm out here, right here, this is my office. I have to be prepared to catch fish. Smallmouth there. I just knew the way that thing pulled, it had to be a smallmouth. Just lean back. It's a nice chunky brown too, look at him. Hey? Nice chunky bronze. Look at him. He's got lots of fight in him. Oh, a really good one too, eh? Wow. Chunky. Whoa, close, you little bugger, eh? Close. Chunky bronze. Bonus. Fishing for largies along the bank. And if you got any rocks and stuff, well, you know what? You get bonus bass too. Like that right there. Nothing wrong with that smallmouth. They bite my plastic. I'm in love. Let's put them back. Hey, nice bronze bass. Go on. Oh yeah. See how those things scrap? There's a small little rock right there, a little rock pile, and he was on it. Boy, oh boy. Just simply incredible. I told you, when you go along the bank, keep your bait wet. I know you say to yourself, okay, I want to find specific targets and stuff, but you'll catch way more fish, including the flukes. That's exactly what they are. But don't call it a fluke because you're keeping your bait in the water. You're fishing. And you're catching fish, you're doing the right thing. The wrong thing is waiting to find the exact things. Fish anything you see, keep your bait wet, and you'll catch them on the bank.
Closed captioning of this program presented by Sportsman Protein Shake.
I want to show you something. Focus has been, we've been catching some fish on the overhanging trees. And you say to yourself, you want to go along the shoreline that has like pads or anything lead in. It doesn't matter. See that rock right there? You say to yourself, it's shale. It's going straight down about 5-6 feet and does the same way underneath these trees and stuff. A lot of guys would just drive by. No way. Honestly, you have to fish everything. It's just like when you pick docks or you're fishing weed edges and things like that. Once you're committed to it, do it. Don't worry about, oh, there's rock, there's not a lot of lead and cover and stuff like that. That's a fallacy. Bass find stuff. And if it's overhanging in shade and stuff, like we're not talking 30-foot bluffs. It's only, I'm in 6 feet of water. But that drops off to about 4 feet right away. It doesn't matter. They will suspend underneath these cedar trees. And it's your job to get your bait underneath those cedar trees, shake it, and wait. Because 99% of the time when they do bite, they'll go out. They got nowhere else to go. They'll go out. You got time to reel in, set hook, catch the fish. But don't worry about those lead and cover and stuff. As long as it's overhanging and it goes back and you can't see the bottom, potentially there could be a fish. When you start fishing trees, fish all the trees. One hiding under a tree again, huh? Look at shoreline trees. Hey. Nice chunk. Look at. I'm gonna jump again. Oh yeah. Nothing wrong with catching bass like that, dudes, right there. We got some nice 2s, 4-pound, 3-pound. And at least we got them, kissed them, photographed, and released. Ready? Go on. Okay, something about robbing the banks and money. What is the color of money? Green. That's it. Gonna keep it real simple. My jigs have green. My plastics have green. Green with a little bit of blue iridescent and green pumpkin with black flake. That's it. Keeping it real simple. So my focus is just putting that bait in those spots, knowing that when they see either one of these or the jig, they will eat it and I'll be making withdrawal from the bank.
Whoa. Hey.
Edge of some rock and weed. Look at that. He's still on the bank. Oh, what a fighter, eh? That scrapping bass. Wow. Oh, yeah.
How you say, eh?
Picture fish. Look at the big mouth on him, eh? Big mouth bass. Sometimes you gotta pitch until you can't pitch no more. And then you catch him. It's like that. I've been pitching all over the place, every nook and cranny. I find a little rock pile with some weeds on it. Might have made 20, 25 pitches and finally in the right spot. And the right spot is where the rock gets dark and there's weed put in. All of a sudden there's weight. And what's there? Boom, largemouth bass. Still along the bank, just out a little ways, wherever there's cover, wherever there's fish. I'm almost done. And potentially boat's going on the trailer pretty soon, but I got a couple more things up my sleeve. A few aces to try before I say, the fat bass has sang. Let's go. Whoa, whoa. That's a nice one. It came out of nowhere.
and a lock. And just like that, eh? You see a log, you put it down, whack! 2+ pounder. Just, you can't pass anything, whether you're on the bank or just off the bank. This bank is all rock and stuff, so I pull out about 15 more feet. See a log, put it down. Oh well.
Birchcliff Lodge, one of Ontario's most picturesque cottage resorts since 1931. Situated on 15 acres on the shore of Baptiste Lake, is 10 kilometers to the village of Bancroft, Ontario. An ideal family vacation destination, Birchcliff offers cottage accommodation of various sizes. Each cottage is freshly decorated and updated with screen porches and some with fireplaces. Enjoy wonderful swimming at the clear sandy beach or tour the lake in the rental boats or kayaks and canoes. Evening sunsets and campfires create lasting memories at Birchcliff Lodge, which has retained its 1930s character and is a popular venue for weddings, conferences, or retreats, and offers spring and fall discounts. The lodge also features a fully equipped playground, horseshoe pit, and ping pong table, as well as badminton and volleyball courts. The clean, sandy beach is weed-free and enters the lake on a gradual slope, making it safe for youngsters. Contact Birchcliff Lodge for your next fishing or family vacation in the Bancroft area. They can be reached at 613-332-3316 or visit them at www.birchcliffslodge.ca.
So here's the beauty of using the power pole, okay? You say to yourself, it's just bling, it's not. I got the breeze pushing me in, and I got this tree, and it's got all kinds of branches on it, and I want to fish it, but I don't want to rush. So I put my poles down, you dig in, then I can just focus on this tree and dissect the different branches that come off it that are tapering down, and I can't see the bottom. If I can't see the bottom, I'm going to fish it. But it just keeps me stationary, and I can just focus on what I'm doing, and that is fishing and potentially catching without having to worry about touching the trolling motor or moving, because sometimes those big fish come out real slow. And there's a reason why they're big, they're weary sometimes. The longer you have to fish, keep your bait in that area without moving it, sometimes that's just the key to catching those fish without having to move it. I can put it wherever I want. When I find stuff I want to fish, that looks very fishy. Just a chunk. Look, just a chunk. A fighting chunk. Sitting on a log, it's coming up off the bank. Oof, thick little chunk, huh? Little chunky, I'll put him right back where he came from. Look, tree coming out all the way from the shore, all the way out here. I made about 5 pitches all the way down to that stuff. Until I put it at the end, where there's a little bit of weed, I got a fish. Now, you know what? It could have been a 5-pounder. But you know what? So what? There's a pounder there. Perfect example. Hitting the trees and the weed edge. See? Under the tree. Look at that fight, hey? Look at that fight. In the boat. Oh, look at that. Look at the head on that, huh? Look at the head on that. That's what happens when you fish those inside weed lines under those trees. Look at that little bait right there. Look at the mouth on that thing. Pretty good sized fish, eh? Look at him. That's pushing some weight there, boy. Yes, sir. Let's put him in there for some pictures, huh? Oh, yeah. Nice, beautiful bass. Put that in manual. Look at him. Inside weed lines and overhanging trees, right there. What have we learned? We learned that to keep the bait in the water. So my focus was a couple of these docks here. Came out and I saw this red cabbage and stuff, and I'm thinking, okay, inside weed edge. Then I look, what is it? It's a rock bluff, but doesn't matter, man. You think, okay, it's straight down. It goes down about 5 feet straight. Fish aren't gonna be there. It's the trees, man. Look at it right there. Those overhanging trees right there, the cedars, the shade close to the weed edge. Whatever, man, right there. He was sitting right under those trees right there, making that pitch. And what do? They go out, always. Wow. Well, what do you think of that? Hey, busting the bank with the Xtreme Bass Angler. I know you saw it before, but boy, oh boy, I cannot get enough of busting the bank in summertime when those bass are big and plentiful. Sometimes they can be a little moody, I'd say, but it doesn't matter. You got a variety of plastics in your jig, and it's all about being focused and concentrating on those trees, the logs, the pads, the fallen trees, the tapering stuff, but everything that's on the bank, coming out from the bank. You want to catch more bass? Seriously, get to the banks, make some withdrawals, kiss them, release them, and leave them for next time for somebody else to enjoy, because you know it, and you saw it right here on this show. The banks are where it's at for big bad bass. We'll see you next time.
The Xtreme Bass Angler has been presented by Young Steel's Ford Lincoln, Gamma Fishing Lines, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Interstate Batteries, Top Gun Marine. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.